Here we go. Let's talk about Lyme disease, because I just got a phone call from a friend of mine who knows two men, her son and her boyfriend, that have these strange symptoms. It sounds like Lyme disease, but you never know what it is, but it could be. And that's the thing about Lyme disease. I had it undiagnosed for quite a few years because doctors in Massachusetts, even though my town is considered one of the Lyme capital towns of the world, Westport, Massachusetts, they don't like to touch it because they don't really know how to treat it, or maybe it's too expensive to treat. I never could figure out why they were so against trying to figure out if you have Lyme disease, if you come in and you've got all kinds of symptoms. But finally, a good friend of mine diagnosed me. When my hair started falling out, she said, "You've got Lyme disease, go get tested." So I went to the family clinic and they said, "Why do you want to be tested for Lyme disease?" And I said, "Because I think I might have it." "Well, we don't think so." "Well, test me anyway."
How do they know that?
They don't know, but they are. That's what you're up against with Lyme disease, I found out. It's very political with the insurance companies. So anyway, I finally found out.
It's a tough cure, it's a tough treatment.
It is tough. And one doctor finally admitted to me, when they try to treat it with antibiotics, it's really a shot in the dark, in many ways, because they don't know specifically. Now, I ended up going to this doctor in Connecticut, Dr. Jones, who treated, I don't even know if he's still practicing, he treated Lyme very, very aggressively, which is controversial with other doctors.
How did he treat us?
Aggressively.
With?
Doxycycline, antibiotics.
Right, doxycycline.
But most of the medical people will just give you a short prescription and maybe not as potent as what this man would do to knock it down. And I finally did get rid of it one day when I shifted my thought finally, because it's important to accept that you will get cured rather than listening to all the crazy talk out there that you never get rid of it. They compare it to syphilis, the little spirochetes. They just keep replicating and you'll never get it out of your system. Well, I got it out of mine because I have no symptoms.
You know how they say it was developed?
Right.
On that island off of Lyme, Connecticut.
Plum Island.
Yes.
No, it was off of Long Island.
Well, yeah, there was an island off of Long Island in between and Connecticut.
Yeah, and it ended up in Lyme, Connecticut, because the birds flew up the coast from Long Island.
And the deers brought it over. That's why
the deer
ticks.
Right.
Right. But you had yours treated that way. We have frequencies that we treat it with.
Well, I also used a lot of other things. I used magnets. I went to an Ayurvedic doctor and had mud wraps to detox my body. I went on a 2-month detoxification program where I ate only very specific things. I cut out meat. I cut out sugar.
Right.
I drank this protein powder every day.
Changing your diet.
Everything. It was a detox.
We use pulsed electromagnetic therapy. We have discs. We have these machines that we talked about in the last video. The MiFi cold plasma. We put the frequencies in. And gets rid of the little spirochetes. And we get rid of parasites. We have frequencies for everything.
Right.
But yeah, hopefully you'll never have to go through that again, because you know
it
how
was
to
a
cure
process.
Right.
It was a process. It took me a few years of suffering and then, you know, finding ways to overcome it before I finally felt like I had beaten it. But it was a process. Sometimes I think maybe it was sent my way to kind of reprogram me. Some people feel that way when they get these autoimmune system problems, because you have to detox, you have to change certain ways that you've been operating.
There's reasons we get these things.
Right, right. I got redirected in the process too. Now, some people die. I mean, I knew some people, or heard about some people, who actually committed suicide.
Oh, yeah.
Because they could not overcome this crippling thing that would put them in a wheelchair or, I mean,
right.
I actually went to a rally in New York City with a bunch of Lyme people because they were taking away this doctor's license. Not the one I went to, but another doctor on Long Island. His license was being threatened by the AMA because he was treating Lyme disease in a very aggressive way. And I talked to people on the bus going into this rally in New York at the Plaza Hotel. One young man told me that he was institutionalized when he was a teenager because they thought he was retarded, but it was really Lyme disease. After he got cured, he was like a different person. There was many stories like that. There were a lot of people at this rally.
There's a lot of cures out there. People just don't understand it, what the healing modalities are that we use. If you want to learn more, you can go to RebeccaTripp.com, go to her website, contact her.
I did a video on my Lyme disease cure called Lyme Gone or something.
So it's on YouTube?
It's on YouTube. My YouTube channel is Inner Power Training Rebecca Tripp on YouTube.
And mine is CharmandShaman.com. We have our healing modalities too. We can explain to you using frequencies for Lyme. Or natural healing is another modality that we use. So get in touch with us.
Definitely.
Ciao, guys. Bye for now.